Overweightness and obesity are the most commonly seen nutrition-related conditions in veterinary practices in more economically developed countries. Being overweight is the result of previously eating more calories than is needed, leading to the accumulation of fat, which is the way the body stores extra energy for later use. Fat tissue is now known to be metabolically active and puts additional stress on the body, leading to other conditions or diseases and a significantly shortened lifespan. Difficulties in breathing and moving are common, leading to a poor quality of life. Unfortunately, given the high prevalence of overweightedness and obesity, they may not be as readily recognized or highlighted by veterinarians as they begin to be accepted as normal. As pets accumulate fat, deposits are found in specific areas of the body, regardless of breed. The size of these deposits can be assessed visually and by touch. The greater the fat accumulation, the more overweight a pet is. Typically, a pet that is 20 to 25% overweight due to excess fat is considered obese. To provide a more precise description of the degree of fatness or adiposity, a body condition scoring system is typically used in veterinary medicine. Body condition scoring systems, also known as BCS, use a number scale to describe the amount of body fat. The most common systems use either a 5-point system or a 9-point system. Larger numbers mean a pet is more overweight. Thus, a pet with a body condition score of 5 out of 5 or 9 out of 9 is considered severely obese. A body condition score of 3 out of 5 or 4 to 5 out of 9 is considered ideal. In a 5-point system, each point above 3 represents being 20 to 30% overweight, while each point above 5 represents being 10 to 15% overweight. There are additional methods to assess body fat, including morphometric measurements, bioelectrical impedance, DEXA, and stable isotope dilution, but these typically are reserved for use in a research setting. Thus, a diagnosis of overweightedness or obesity is made with a simple physical examination by one's veterinarian. Often, one's veterinarian will want to do some tests to rule out an underlying cause for the weight gain, like hypothyroidism, before a weight loss plan is initiated. Such routine blood work and urinalysis can make sure that any weight loss that is subsequently achieved is due to intentional caloric restriction and not another disease leading to poor appetite or malabsorption that may be harmful if ignored. Once a pet is identified as being in need of weight loss, key nutritional therapy strategies are used as part of an active weight loss plan. Although in concept achieving weight loss is extremely simple, just feed less calories than are needed, successfully achieving weight loss can actually be quite challenging. The initial challenge is determining the amount of calories that are needed. There are several equations to determine caloric need based on a pet's body weight, age, and sexual status. However, these equations can be off by as much as plus or minus 50%. Thus, the best way to determine an individual pet's caloric need is to determine the amount of calories that leads to weight stability. This can be accomplished by completing a detailed diet history form. Such a form will ask about all foods fed, including any treats. One's veterinarian or veterinary nutritionist can then add up the calories from all foods, including treats, to more accurately predict a pet's specific energy need. If the total amount of calories fed cannot be determined, then one can rely solely on the energy equations, recognizing that initial recommendations may be more likely to lead to over or underfeeding. Overfed pets will not lose and may even gain weight, while underfed pets will lose weight too fast and be uncomfortable during weight loss. The goal is for the amount of calories fed to lead to weight loss at a rate of 0.5 to 2% of body weight loss per week. Achieving this rate relies heavily on typically biweekly weigh-ins, where the amount fed is adjusted up or down based on response. As less calories are fed to enable weight loss, one needs to ensure that essential nutrients do not become deficient at the same time. Typically, pet food is formulated to provide a certain amount of each essential nutrient per calorie. Since dogs and cats eat to meet their caloric need normally, this approach results in enough each nutrient being eaten daily. However, if less calories than what are needed are fed to enable weight loss, less essential nutrients will also be fed daily, leading to the potential for developing a deficiency over time. To avoid this, foods designed for active weight loss are typically nutrient enhanced. This means that they have more nutrients per calorie than a normal maintenance food. Thus, when less calories are fed, essential nutrients like protein and amino acids, fatty acids, minerals, and vitamins do not become deficient. Sometimes folks will feed less of a maintenance food to try and initiate weight loss or prevent weight gain, and then see the effects of unintentionally created deficiencies on coat quality as protein, amino acids, linoleic acid, vitamin A, B vitamins, and trace minerals like zinc all play an important role in skin and coat health. Usually there is a limit to how much nutrient enhancement exists, so there may be limits put on the degree of restriction, the rate of weight loss per week, and/or the amount of treats fed due to concerns about creating deficiencies. One of the limitations that prevents the rate of weight loss from being more than 2% of body weight per week is that greater rates of weight loss are associated with increased hunger. As hunger is uncomfortable for the pet, it also may lead to undesirable behaviors like excessive begging or vocalizations and activity when folks wish to sleep, attempts are made to limit hunger dietarily. Reducing a food's energy density or the calories per cup or unit of volume allows for more food to be fed without concurrently giving more calories. This larger volume of food can lead to an increased sense of fullness or satiety compared to if the same amount of calories were fed but in a smaller volume. Thus, foods designed for active weight loss typically use dietary fiber, water, and/or increased air pockets and kibble to decrease the amount of calories the food provides per can or cup or unit of volume. It is worth noting that fiber-rich ingredients can often be relatively expensive and are not being used as a filler to drive costs down in foods designed for weight loss, but rather are specially added to help a pet feel more comfortable during weight loss. Caloric distribution refers to the percent of calories that come from protein, fat, and carbohydrate in a food. Beyond the needed increase in protein calories to enable nutrient enhancement, there are times when additional modifications to the caloric distribution are made for foods designed for active weight loss. Most commonly, a lower carbohydrate approach may be attempted, especially with cat foods. Using a lower carbohydrate approach may slightly increase a pet's metabolic rate, leading to slightly more rapid weight loss with the same amount of caloric restriction. At times, this benefit may be overshadowed by any concurrent increase in energy density as satiety may be reduced in some pets. This occurs when dietary fat increases to lower the amount of calories from carbohydrate, as fat is more than twice as energy dense as protein or carbohydrate. Some suggest that higher protein and/or fat levels may lead to more satiety when the same volume of food is fed, but this is still debated and not consistently seen clinically. Fortunately, there are some options for foods that are lower in carbohydrate calories and are still less energy dense due to the use of additional fiber and/or water if one wishes to try this approach. At the same time, some weight loss foods may be lower in fat to help decrease the food's energy density beyond what can be achieved with additional fiber, water, and/or air pockets. During active weight loss, increasing feeding frequency can be useful as it may increase the thermic effect of food, also known as diet-induced thermogenesis, which is the amount of calories one uses to digest food. More importantly, increasing the number of meals per day as well as providing a predetermined amount of treats, can provide one with accounted-for options to address begging or signs of hunger by the pet. To be effective, one must carefully portion control food and treats to make sure that the total amount of calories fed daily is still restricted. Specific treat selection can also be important, as certain treats may be better options than others. Treats that are less energy dense are often preferable, as they allow more treating than more energy dense options. Given a choice, most pets would prefer more of an enjoyable but less energy dense treat than far less of a really enjoyable but more energy dense treat. As treats are not usually nutrient enhanced or even complete and balanced, they should be limited to prevent creating a deficiency by caloric dilution. As a rough rule, no daily treat amount should exceed 10% of the total daily calories fed. Carnitine is a natural compound found in cells that is involved in the transport of fatty acids from fat into the mitochondria, where the fatty acids are used for energy production by the body's cell. Although L-carnitine can be made from amino acids by the body, there is evidence that supplemental L-carnitine can help with the burning of fat by the body. As such, L-carnitine is commonly added to foods specifically designed for active weight loss. There are additional nutrients that are also suggested to have beneficial effects, including compounds found in common fruits and vegetables. Thus, some foods may have these added to them, or it may be suggested that fresh fruits and vegetables be added as specific treats. In addition, there are other compounds that have been suggested to be helpful, like conjugated linoleic acid, that subsequently have proven to not be effective in controlled veterinary studies. Pets can benefit from exercise during active weight loss. A simple daily walk or play session can be helpful in maintaining a pet's muscle mass. However, exercise alone should not be relied on to achieve weight loss. This is because the amount of calories burned, even with relatively regular exercise, is typically a magnitude less than the calorie reduction that can be achieved with feeding smaller portion-controlled meals. Often exercise is most important in providing a pet positive attention and an activity that is enjoyed with the added benefit of burning some additional calories. The specific amount of weight loss food that needs to be fed commonly has to be adjusted based on individual response. Even the best of foods will not result in weight loss unless the amount fed is changed based on whether the pet is losing weight at the desired rate of weight loss of 0.5 to 2% of body weight per week or not. If portions are adjusted according to frequent weight checks, the weight loss plan is very likely to be successful. Failure to alter the amount of daily calories from food and treats that are fed dooms all weight loss plans. Once a pet has achieved the desired body condition, a slow weaning onto a new, less energy-dense maintenance food, or if preferred to the existing weight loss food, to achieve weight stability can be done. With the right weight loss plan and adjustments in the amount of special weight loss food fed, pets can be restored to an appropriate body condition and hopefully live longer, better quality lives.